Welcome to Learn Commerce PU online classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello everyone, welcome to second PUC statistics online classes. In the previous class we had discussed about how to solve second applications of t-test problems. In this class we are going to discuss the remaining problems of second test of t-test, second applications of t-test problems. In that, problem number 3, that is the marks obtained by two groups of students in a statistics test are given below. Here the given informations are, there are two set of observations are given. The first set of observation is group A and another set of observation is group B. And here given informations are number of students, mean marks, standard deviation of marks of these two set of observations. And on the basis of this data, can it conclude that there is a significant difference in the mean in marks by the two groups and alpha is equal to 0.05. Okay, now let's see the given solutions. See here, number of students is given. Number of students in the sense what? That is sample size. So here sample size is given. There are two set of observations is there, no? So here I will write, first set of observation is sample size is denoted by N1. And another set of sample size is denoted by N2. So here N1 is 15 and N2 is 11. See here 15 and 11 are less than 30. See here 15 and 11 are less than 30. So this is t-tail test. And next, sorry, this is t-test, okay, not t-tail, this is t-test. And next, see here, mean marks are given. Mean marks in the sense what? That is sample mean marks. So sample mean marks is denoted by x bar. And here two set of observations are there. That is why I will write x bar 1 is equal to 42 and x bar 2 is equal to 38. Next, standard deviation of these two observations are given. So standard deviation is denoted by S, and here two set of observations are there, no? That is why I will write S1 is equal to 10 and S2 is equal to 15, and alpha is given, that is 5%. See 0.05 in the sense what? That is 5%. Alpha is level of significance. Next, move to test procedure. See here the question is like this. What it is? Can it conclude that there is a significance difference in the mean marks by the two groups? See that significant difference in the sense what? That is, there is no equal to. So if it is not equal to type, then it is alternative hypothesis. Alternative hypothesis is step 2 and it is denoted by H1. Here the step 1 is H0, that is null hypothesis. And here the given in this problem is based on alternative hypothesis, that is mean marks. So there is a significant difference in the mean marks of two groups. So H1 is, there is significant difference in the mean marks of two group. See that we can write mu1 is not equal to mu2, and we know that H0 is always equal to tau, isn't it? So when it is equal mu1 is equal to mu2, see there is no significant difference between the marks of two groups, then we can say mu1 is equal to mu2. Therefore, H0 is, there is no significance difference between the difference in the marks of two groups. Okay, now let's move to test procedure, that is step 3. So here step 3 is test statistic, and this is t test. So t is equal to x bar 1 minus x bar 2 divided by square root of SSC square into 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2, which follows t with n1 plus n2 minus 2 degrees of freedom. See, here x bar 1, x bar 2, n1, n2 observations are given in the problem. Here we need to find SSC square. SSC square formula is n1 s1 square plus n2 s2 square divided by n1 plus n2 minus 2. So here n1 observation is given, that is 15 into observation, that is 10. So we have to take here square is there, so we need to take 10 square plus 11 into 15 square divided by n1, that is 15 plus 11 minus 2. Okay, this is equal to, see here, 10 square is 100, 100 into 15, that is 1500, plus here 50 square is 225, 225 into 11, that is 2475, divided by 15 plus 11, that is 26, minus 2, that is 24, and this is equal to 1500 plus 2475 is 2475, that is 3970 divided by 24, that is 165.4. So here SSC square value is 165.4. okay, now I will substitute all these values under this formula. This is equal to x bar 1, so here x bar 1 is 42 minus x bar 2, that is 38, divided by square root of here SSC square, that is 165.4 into 1 by n1. So here n1 is 15, so 1 by 15 plus n2 is 11, so that is 1 by 11. This is equal to 42 minus 38, that is 4, divided by here the square root of 165.4 into 1 by 15, that is 0.066, plus 1 by 11, that is 0.090. This is equal to 0.066 plus 0.090, that is 0.156 into 165.4, that is 25.8024, then 4 divided by 25.8024, that is 0.155. This is calculated value. So here calculated value is 0.155. okay, this is step 3. Okay, next move to step 4. Step 4 is, here alpha is 5%, 5% level of significance, and here degrees of freedom. So how to find out degrees of freedom? Here the formula is n1 plus n2 minus 2. So here n1 observation, here n1 is 15 and n2 is 11 minus 2, that is 24. So here degrees of freedom is 24, alpha is 5%. See, this is not equal to type. See, if it is not equal to type, then it is two-tailed test. Okay, and if two-tailed, see, next, see, this is two-tailed test, and here alpha is 5%, and here degrees of freedom is 24, therefore here k value is 2.06. yes, your test is two-tailed. Therefore, critical values are, that is minus k is equal to minus 2.06 and k value is 2.06. And see, this is two-tailed test in the sense what? Here rejection region located both the tails of probability curve. So, this is rejection region and this is rejection region. So, here this value is minus k, that is minus 2.06, and this is plus k value, that is 2.06, and this is acceptance region. See, this is rejection region, this is rejection region and this is acceptance region. Okay, now see here calculated value is 0.15155. So, that value lies here. See, this central value is 0 and that value lies here, calculated value lies here. So, that value is 0 point calculated value, that is this one, that is 0.155. See, here calculated value lies in acceptance region, therefore, H naught accepted. Here calculated value is lies in acceptance region, therefore, H naught accepted. Or one more condition is, this is two-tailed test in the sense the condition is minus k less than or equal to calculated value less than or equal to k. Here minus k value is minus 2.06 and calculated value is 0.155 and the k value is 2.06. Okay, first I will consider these two observations. Here 0.155 is greater than minus 2.06, so the sign is like this. Next, I will consider these two observations. Here 2.06 is greater than 0.155, therefore the sign is like this. See, here the conditions are satisfied. So, if condition is satisfied, then we can say H naught accepted. If H naught accepted, the conclusion is there is no significant difference in the marks of two groups. So, the conclusion there is no significant difference between significant in difference in the marks of two groups. That is mu 1 is equal to mu 2. Okay, this is the conclusion. Next, problem number 4, that is, for the following data, examine whether the mean differs significantly. Here alpha is given, that is 0.05, and given observations are sample 1 and sample 2. There are two set of observations are given. And here sample size, mean, standard deviation of sample 1 and sample 2 observations are given. Next, let's see the solution part. Here given informations are, see here sample size is denoted by n, here two set of observations are given. So, here n1 is 12 and n2 is 7. See here 12 and 7 is more than 30, so this is t test. Next, means are given, sample mean is given, that is sample mean is denoted by x bar. Here two set of observations are given. So, I will write first set of sample mean is x bar 1, that is 57.2. Then x bar 2 is 52.3. Next, sample standard deviations are given, that is x1 is 3.41. Then x2, that is 3.642. And here level of significance is given, that is alpha is equal to 0.05, that we can write 5%. Okay, next, let's see the test procedure. See the question. So, your question is, for the following data, examine whether mean differs significantly. See, here differs significantly in the sense what, that is not equal to. So, So not equal in the sense that is alternative hypothesis. So alternative hypothesis denoted by H1. So this is step 2, and step 1 is null hypothesis, and null hypothesis denoted by H0. So here the given sentence is the mean difference differs significantly. So I will write here. So here given statement is alternative hypothesis. So therefore I will write here there is significant difference between mean of samples. So I will write mu1 is not equal to mu2. Then our null hypothesis is equal to type. So we will write mu1 is equal to mu2. Okay, mu1 is not equal to mu2. See, if it is not equal to type, we can say this is two-tailed test. And see, this is equal when it is equal, mu1 is equal to mu2. If there is no significant difference between mean of samples, then we can write mu1 is equal to mu2. So here null hypothesis is there is no significant difference between means of samples, that we can write mu1 is equal to mu2. Then step 3 is test statistic. That is t is equal to x bar 1 minus x bar 2 divided by square root of sc square into 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2, which follows t with n1 plus n2 minus 2 degrees of freedom. Okay, now see in the given observation, see the question. In this problem they given x bar 1, x bar 2, n1 and n2. So here we need to find xc square. So xc square formula is n1 s1 square plus n2 s2 square divided by n1 plus n2 minus 2. Okay, this is equal to, see here n1 observation is 12 into x1 square. So your x1 is, I will write like this, 12 into 3.41 square plus here n2 observation, that is 7, into s2 observation is 3.62. Here we need squared that term. Then n1, that is 12 plus n2 is 7 minus 2. Okay, this is equal to c 3.41 square is 11.6281 into 12, that is 139.53, plus here 3.62 square is 13.104 into 7, that is 91.73, divided by 12 plus 7, that is 19, so minus 2, that is 17. Okay, this is equal to 139.53 plus 91.73, the value is 231.26 divided by 17, that is 13.60. So here SSC square value is 13.60. Okay, now I will substitute all these values under this formula. That is x bar 1 is 57.2 and x bar 2 is 52.3 divided by square root of SSC square, that is 13.6. Yes, 13.6 into 1 by 12 plus 1 by 7. Okay, this is equal to 57.2 minus 52.3, that is 4.9, which is divided by square root of 13.6 into 1 by 12, that is 0.083, plus 1 by 7, that is 0.142. Okay, now see here, that is this is square root of 13.6 into 0.083 plus 0.142. See, here 0.083 plus 0.142 into 13.6, the square root of that answer is 2.801. Here the denominator is 4.9 divided by 2.801. 4.9 divided by 2081 is 2.8. See here, calculated value is 2.8. See, this is step 3. Next, move to step 4. Step 4 is, here alpha is 5% level of significance and degrees of freedom. See, that is N1 plus N2 minus 2. Here N1 observation is 12 and N2 is 7 minus 2. See, 12 plus 7 is 19, 19 minus 2 is 17. So, here degrees of freedom is 17. And here test is two-tailed test. Therefore, critical values are -k and plus k. Okay. See, here alpha is 5% and degrees of freedom is 17. So, here critical values are -2.11 and 2.11, and this is two-tailed test, in the sense what, here rejection region located at both the tails of probability curve like this, and this is minus k. Here minus k is -2.11 and plus k is 2.11. See, this is rejection region. And this is rejection region and this is acceptance region. See, here calculated value is 2.8. That 2.8 lies here. Yes, this is 2.8. So, this is calculated value. And see, here calculated value lies in acceptance region. Therefore, H not accepted. Here, calculated value lies in acceptance region. Therefore, H not accepted. And one more condition is there in two-tailed, that is, or in the two-tailed, the condition is minus k less than or equal to calculated value less than or equal to critical value. See here, minus k value is -2.11 and calculated value is 2.8 and the k value is 2.11. See here, first I will consider these two observations. See here, 2.8 is greater than -2.11, and next here 2.11 is greater than 2.8. See here, condition is satisfied. Therefore, H naught is accepted. If H not accepted, the condition is there is no significant difference between means of samples. Therefore, conclusion is there is no significant difference between mean of samples, that is mu 1 is equal to mu 2. This is the conclusion. Yes, thank you for watching this video.
Don't forget. forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.